Good morning. My name is Sean Hudgenwardle, and I will be your moderator for this morning's class. And welcome to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research. This is a school, and it is not a church. Neither are we affiliated with any religious organization. This school is a nonprofit, non-denominational, religious and scientific research organization dedicated to showing proof of the existence of Yahweh, our Elohim, and the operation of his eternal purpose, pattern, and plan operating throughout eternity to this present day. This school was established as a result of a divine vision and revelation given to our founder, Dr. Henry Clifford Kinley, in the state of Ohio in the year of 1931. We were incorporated in the state of California in 1958. Since then, we've established various branch schools throughout the United States and in various foreign countries. The Ontario branch was established in May of 1988. At this time, I would like to introduce to you the Dean of the Ontario branch, Dr. Marlon Love, and the President of the Ontario branch, Dr. Christopher Williams. In this school, we use the true, correct, and original name and title of the Father, the Word or Son, and the Holy Spirit, as contained in the original Hebrew text. The true name of our Heavenly Father is Yahweh. It has been improperly substituted by Lord. The true title of the Word or Son is Elohim. It has been improperly substituted by God. The name of the Holy Spirit, manifested in or out of a physical body, is Yahshua. It has been erroneously substituted by Jesus Christ. Lord and God are titles, and they are not names. The Apostle Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, tells us in 1 Corinthians 8 and 5 that there are Lords many and Gods many. But we now know that each Lord must have a name, and each God must have a name also. Elohim is a title, but unlike Lord and God, Elohim is a divine title. This means that Elohim is a title that our Creator chose for himself. Jesus is a name, but it is an erroneous name. A minor investigation on your part into a good dictionary or encyclopedia would prove that neither the Hebrew, Greek, nor Latin languages have any letters in their alphabet that would produce the sound that is made by this letter J. Neither was there a letter J in the English language until some 1,400 years after the Messiah's death. Therefore, such names as Jesus and Jehovah are impossible renderings for the true and original name of our Father and His Son. Christ is a title, just like Lord and God. Yahweh is pure spirit, and in this state, he is incomprehensible and inscrutable. He is the ultimate source, substance, limits, and bounds of everything. We have Yahweh in his pure spirit state symbolized on this chart as a cloud. Yahweh is not a cloud. He merely chose a cloud to symbolize himself because a cloud has no particular or descriptive shape and form. We have this cloud drawn all around the edges of this chart to show you that everything on this chart is within the cloud. In like manner, everything in the universe abides within the pure spirit state of Yahweh. A Yahweh, knowing that man could not perceive of him in this pure spirit state, took on shape and form right within himself as Elohim. Excuse me. This is the Word or Son, a superincorporeal being, that is, having the shape and form of a man, but without having flesh and blood. This shape and form can only be seen in divine visions and understood in divine revelations. Later on, this self-same spirit manifested himself in a physical body and walked the earth plane as Yahshua the Messiah, whom the world calls Jesus Christ. Now, there's only one name given unto salvation, and we all must know this name. So the simple yet intelligent question that we should ask ourselves is, what was the name of the Savior during the time that he walked the earth plane? A further understanding of this name and title may be had by reading the preface of the Holy Name Bible. Also in this school, we teach by the divine pattern of the universe. It is called the divine pattern because it is Yahweh's pattern. After Yahweh led the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt, he instructed Moses to come atop of Mount Sinai, where he showed him a tabernacle pattern in a vision. He instructed Moses to build one exactly like it in the wilderness of Sinai. This tabernacle consists of a most holy place, a holy place, and a court round about. These three compartments make up the one tabernacle pattern. In this school, we show proof that everything in the universe is made and operates according to the structure and function of this threefold tabernacle pattern, and that absolutely nothing escapes the pattern. The 10 primary constitutional aims and objectives of the Institute are as follows. First is to help you find and know Yahweh, our Elohim, as he really is and actually exists. Second is to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood of humanity in Yahshua the Messiah, without distinction of race, nationality, creed, sex, caste, or color. Third is to investigate the unexplained spirit law, or so-called law of nature, and the powers latent in man. Fourth is to encourage and promote the study of the scriptures, comparative religions, psychology, philosophy, and modern practical and occult science. Fifth is to extirpate current superstition, skepticism, and ignorance. Sixth is to learn, know, and understand the operation of Yahweh's eternal purpose through the dispensations and ages. Seventh is to discern and avoid being deceived by Lucifer, the serpent, the devil, the dragon, or Satan and his demons operating the mystery of iniquity on earth through the dispensations of time. Eighth is to earnestly contend for the common salvation and faith which was once delivered to the sons or children of Yahweh. Ninth is to make known that Yahweh from the beginning ordained that there is no other name given among men whereby man can be saved, saving the name of Yahshua the Messiah. And tenth is to inherit eternal life now in the kingdom of Yahshua the Messiah with the hope of immortal glorification in the new earth state. Our watchword is peace. Our slogan is speak the truth. Today we will begin with a prayer by Dr. Aaron Alanis, and that will be followed by a selection of music. Our scripture lesson will be Galatians, the third chapter, and that will be read by Dr. Eunice Reiser.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Let us all bow our hearts and minds. Dear Heavenly Father Yahweh, we gather again in your name to learn more about your purpose, pattern, and plan, and to give thanks for the gift that we do not deserve, and to give thanks for everything that you've shown us so far. And I just pray that whoever gets up here, the vessel that is up here, can clearly convey exactly what you want them to. And we ask all these things in your only begotten Son's name, Yahshua the Messiah. Let us all say, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Morning, class. Morning. Our scripture lesson will be taken from Galatians, the third chapter, page 252, and I'll be reading out of the Holy Name Bible containing the Holy Name version of the Old and New Testament, critically compared with ancient authorities and various manuscripts, revised by the late A.B. Trainum, Scripture Research Association, Incorporated. Galatians, the third chapter, page 252. O foolish Galatians! Who has bewitched you, that ye should not obey the truth, before whose eyes Yahshua the Messiah has been evidently set forth as crucified among you? This only would I learn of you. Receive ye the Spirit by the works of the law, or by the hearing of faith? Are ye so foolish, having begun in the spirit? Are ye now made perfect by the flesh? Have ye suffered so many things in vain, if it be yet in vain? He therefore that ministereth to you the Spirit, and worketh miracles among you, doth he it by the workings of the law, or by the hearing of faith? Even as Abraham believed Yahweh, and it was accounted to him for righteousness. Know ye therefore that they which are of faith, the same are the children of Abraham. And the scripture, foreseeing that Yahweh would justify the heathens through faith, preached before the gospel unto Abraham, saying, in thee shall all nations be blessed. So then they which be of faith are blessed with faithful Abraham. For as many as are of the works of the law are under the curse. For it is written, cursed is every one that continueth not in all things which are written in the book of the law to do them. But that no man is justified by the law in the sight of Yahweh, it is evident, for the just shall live by faith. Now the law is not of faith, but the man that doeth these things shall live by them. The Messiah has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth on a tree, that the blessing of Abraham might come on the nations through Yahshua the Messiah, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. Brethren, I speak after the manner of men. Though it be but a man's covenant, yet if it be confirmed, no man disannulleth or addeth thereto. Now to Abraham and his seed were the promises made. He said not, and to seeds, plural, but to seed, singular, which is his Messiah. And this I say, that the covenant that was confirmed before Yahweh in his Messiah, the law, which came 430 years after, cannot disannul, that it should make the promise of none effect. For if the inheritance be by the law, it is no more by promise, but Yahweh gave it to Abraham by promise. Wherefore then serveth thee the law? It was added because of transgressions, till the seed should come to whom the promise was made. And it was ordained by angels in the hand of a mediator. Now a mediator is not a mediator of one, but Yahweh is one. Is the law then against the promise of Yahweh? By no means. For if there had been a law given which could have given life, verily righteousness should have been by the law. But the scripture has concluded all under sin, that the promise by faith of Yahshua the Messiah might be given to them that believe. But before faith came, we were kept under the law, shut up unto the faith which should afterwards be revealed. Wherefore, the law was our schoolmaster to bring us unto the Messiah, that we might be justified by faith. But after that faith has come, we are no longer under a schoolmaster, for ye are all the children of Yahweh by faith in Yahshua the Messiah. For as many of you as have been baptized in the Messiah have put on the Messiah. There is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither bond nor free, there is neither male nor female, for ye are all one in Yahshua the Messiah. And if ye be the Messiah's, then are ye Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. I have read the third chapter of Galatians. Let us all say hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Good morning again. Thank you, Dr. Alanese, and thank you, Dr. Reiser. Before we get started today, I would like to announce some visitors that we have with us. First, I would like to welcome our returning visitor, guest of Don Thomas, Dwayne Murrell, Murrell, I'm sorry if I'm messing up your name. But thank you for coming back with us. We're glad to have you, and we hope something is said to encourage you to come back and visit us again. It's your second time, so thank you. And we also have some visitors from out of town with us, visiting from Las Vegas. We have Dr. Leslie Lyons. Thank you. And we also have visiting with us from the New Orleans West Bank class, Dr. Arden Jones. Arden Michael Jones. We'd like to welcome our visitors in the Bonds of Peace. We're glad to have you with us here today. Today, we will have a three-speaker format, and for our first speaker, I would like to call visiting from our New Orleans West Bank class, Dr. Arden Michael Jones.
Okay, all right. Hallelujah, class. This is my favorite class. That's the first thing I said when I walked in. Man, you just got to come visit Ontario. It's just got charts all around. You see the 40-plate charts. And the most beautiful charts in the school, I think. Yeah, and they... But it's always a privilege and honor just to be able to say anything about this divine vision and revelation that our founder was given via or by way of Yahweh in the year 1931, you see. And we wouldn't be here, and we wouldn't have a clue as to anything, I mean anything about God. See? See? And just to be clear, I might mention Henry Clifford Kennedy's name, right? Because he was the one that Yahweh chose to give the divine vision and revelation to. But that was just a piece of flesh. See? So the carnal mind gets caught up in giving credit to the flesh instead of the spirit, right. You see? It's very important for us to understand, you see? Now, when Dr. Kinley had the divine vision and revelation, he died. He was gone, right? He said, if you ain't know me before 1931, you ain't never knew me. Right? Ain't that something? Interesting. I don't know if everybody believe that, because they give credit to the name associated with the physical body instead of the name that's the original name, which is Yahweh. And that's incorrect, you see. That shouldn't be occurring, but it's par for the course, you see. You see? See, if Dr. Kinley was the savior, then what we should be saying is, in the year 1931, the spirit of Dr. Kinley came down and got in the body of Dr. Kinley. We got to worship him in what? Spirit and in truth, right? Right? You see? That's why he said he died in 1931, because Yahweh killed him. Now, no man could see Yahweh and live. That's what happened to Moses at the burning bush. He said, the place that thou now standest is holy ground. You know what we thought? You know what people think he was talking about? Some ground. Some land. But he was talking about land, though, because we made out of dust of the ground, right? Now, the place that now thou now standest is holy ground, because Yahweh Elohim had got in that body. You see? You see? In the scripture lesson right there, it said, cursed, everything that's cursed that hanging on a tree, right? Mm-hmm. What does that mean? Mm-hmm. What does that mean? See? See, what you come to realize in this school, that an angel is represented by a tree. A tree and an angel are one and the same. Just like you have a symbiotic relationship with the tree that sets off the oxygen. And what does it do? We intake it, right? But what intakes that? Your flesh, right? You see, because you, everything here, see right there, you got a tree and you got a serpent wrapped around a tree, right? You ever notice that? You ever notice they got a serpent wrapped around a tree in a garden? Pretty interesting, huh? Right? That tree is like an angel. Remember he said, I see men walking as trees. You see? See, he was looking past the flesh. You see? You see? Now, the serpent that's wrapped, that represent the flesh that's wrapped around your bones. Because the bone represents the tree. The tree represents the bone, and that's the symbiotic relationship. The angelic being in your body, right, is wrapped around with flesh. Good and evil. One good, one evil. The flesh. Now, you are here worshiping the name associated with the physical fleshly body, not giving credit to the body that was in the body. You see? 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 And that was expressly forbid by Yahweh. See? 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 Expressly forbid. You see? See? It said the flesh profited nothing, right? Right? You see that? It's pretty. But everybody don't know that, though. So all you got to do is, they say, but we still in these bodies. See, we got to watch that one. But anyway, let's move on. Now, we don't worship no man down here because Yahweh is not a man. How you like that? Yahweh ain't no man. Yahweh is the creator, right? He created men. He took on shape and form as a man. It's the word of son. And the word of son is doing the father's will. And the father is pure spirit. And he's on this chart, you see, surrounds this chart, see? And you abide within him, and you're his offspring. You see, don't let nobody, when you first came in here, that's the first thing you heard, in him we live and move and have our being, right? All right? You going to read that scripture? Because, you know, people might think I'm lying. In him we live and move and have our being, and how? What's the rest of it? See? See? You as offspring, that's my point. See, this is your parental substance. See? See? See, this is your parental substance, right? And everything in the creation came forth from this parental substance, right? See, just source. What source means? What does source mean? Where something comes from.
Right.
What does substance mean? What is made of?
Right.
Now, get in the school book, look up the word holy in the glossary.
All right.
Okay?
You want me to read Acts 17:28?
Yeah, you can read that real quick.
For in him mm-hmm. we live and move mm-hmm. and have our being, uh-huh. as some of your own poets have said.
Uh-huh.
For we are also his offspring.
Oh, no, you're the offspring off of what? Now, this is what we don't clearly understand, because if you never understand this, you'll never understand this teaching. What I'm about to tell you right now, the words I'm about to speak right now, read. Out the school book. Yahweh Elohim put a glossary in the school book, right? And within the realm of the school book, he explains, like a glossary does, it explains the usage of the words within the text, right? In other words, the glossary is explaining the usage of the words within the actual text that you're reading. It's not like a dictionary. It's like a dictionary, but it's not a dictionary because it's very specific. It's more defined. A dictionary have 100 words, 100, see.
You want holy?
Glossary.
Holy. Sacred, spiritually perfect, pure.
What? Well, did you just say holy was what?
Sacred, spiritually perfect, and pure.
Pure. In other words, Yahweh Elohim came down, got in the body, told us that Yahweh was what? Pure spirit. And the glossary tells us that pure spirit is the what spirit? Holy Spirit. Ain't that something? They don't ever preach that from the floor. They just say pure spirit. It's the Holy Spirit. See? Now, once you understand your parental substance and that everything in the entire universe came forth from what? Pure spirit, right? Everything animate, inanimate, known, unknown, visible, invisible, huh? Is that about everything? So now, if everything came forth from pure spirit, and pure spirit, according to the glossary in the school book, is the Holy Spirit, right? Then guess what? By simple, reasonable, common deduction, right? You should come to realize that you're the Holy Spirit. You can't be nothing else but that. But you've been tricked and duped and told that you're not the Holy Spirit.
Right.
You need an exchange to get that. Oh, no. Well, the teachings say everything came forth from pure spirit.
Right.
Right? Now, you could blaspheme against the Holy Spirit, which is the only sin that will not be forgiven. Now, what's that blasphemy? To say you ain't the Holy Spirit? Somebody getting mad now. I'm just trying to open up, spark your pure mind. Because Yahweh Elohim, what he said, he meant. Now, we're in a perilous time right now. Very perilous time. I don't think we understand how perilous this time is. You see? 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 As a matter of fact, we got to walk around wearing masks. Now, remember we should show you the name in the face, right? Now you got to put a mask on your face. Yahweh, y'all don't want to believe that you're Yahweh? Put some masks on. You see? And see, look, everybody wearing masks because they scared of what? The who? What kind of virus is it?
Corona.
Coronavirus. Oh, no. Now, hold on. Now, I know y'all probably didn't hear. Oh. Coronavirus. Well, let's take a look at the coronavirus for a second. Let's look at that. What does it do? Did I spell that right?
Yep.
Hmm. Oh, what you said? Make you can't breathe. Interesting. Well, now, when we came in this class, Yahweh gave us a witness to the fact that everybody was Yahweh because he said, you breathe my name. Right? 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 You go. However, in this school, in about 2006, right, they stopped saying that you needed to say the name. Right? In other words, it was about 2006. Oh, boy. See? See, they had a hurricane that happened in New Orleans, in Katrina, and then the whole school change, 2005, they got a hurricane happening today. See, Yahweh got a perfect timetable. Oh, I'm a roll. Look. And see, you start hearing, we ain't giving no praise to Yahweh. I'm giving all the praise and credit and honor and glory to this body of Henry Clifford County. That's when that started. Okay? And it took, look, it took exactly 10 years for you to hear lectures out of L.A. where everybody's worshiping and praising Yahweh Elohim and Yahshua. And then by 2016, you didn't hear Yahweh Elohim and Yahshua coming on the floor no more. He took his name out their mouth. See? He took his name out their mouth. You understand? See? Now watch this. This is pretty. Now watch. See, in 2018, this is the exact timetable now. 2018, you ever heard of a coronation ball before? You ever heard of that? Let me explain to you what that is. I know very well what that is. And the reason I know is this, because I'm from New Orleans. And in New Orleans, they have Mardi Gras parades. And these Mardi Gras parades, right? As a matter of fact, as a kid, I grew up across the street from the place that they built the floats. You ever heard of a Mardi Gras float? Now those things are all white, and then they paint on them, just like these shorts are all white, and then they paint on them. That's what they do. Now the floats go up and down the street. See, up and down the street, they float, clouds. That's what a cloud is, a float. See, a float is a cloud, see? And they get, the people get on it, and they throw these worthless junk off the, see? But what they do, before they have the parade, they have what's called a coronation ball. And they take, and they vote on a king, and then they get a king, put him on a first float. They have a ball, right? And then they put a crown on the king's head at the ball. Did you know RDMR had a coronation ball? Did y'all know that? Some of y'all saying yes, some of y'all saying no. You know that? 500 of the elite of IDMR, see, the elite. Do you know this?
No.
They have them right down the street in Bannon. The WWW. Y'all don't know who that is. Ooh, I can't tell you who that is. Had a dream one day, one night. And what we're going to do is have a celebration for the international dean. And they set up a coronation ball. And 500 of them got together, right? Okay, right down the street in Bannon, right? I'm surprised y'all don't know that happened. But anyway, hold on now. This is happening in 2018 now. Now look, I'm telling you, Yahweh don't play. All right? Now, 2018, see, toward the end of 2018, see, they had this coronation ball. And guess what they had? They had the people walking in, it was a banquet, and they had trumpet players at the door going, but da 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 da. In IDMR. And they had three people sitting on the throne. I ain't gonna say no names, but international this, soon to be international this, and some in another almost international. Now just for lack of a better word, they're guilty. That rhymes with something. see. Now look, now what happened? You see, they took crowns and put on their heads. They had a coronation ball, and the people got down and worshiped them as they passing by. Now, I wasn't there, but there was a dean that came down to the New Orleans West Bank, and he gave a vivid demonstration oh, what happened? Now, nobody in the class knew that that thing had went on, just like some of y'all don't know. Mm. All right? They didn't know, right? See? Now, keep in mind, they went from preaching Yahshua to not preaching Yahshua, to substituting Yahshua's name, just like the world substitute Jesus for Yahweh, for Yahshua, right? Now look, this pretty. Just watch, stay with me. See? 2018, they had the coronation ball, and Yahweh repudiated that. See? Now what you gotta understand, what Yahweh Elohim told us about this teaching is this, that you gotta look at the world to understand what's going on in class, and you look at class, look in class to see what's gonna happen in the world. Right? See what's going on in the world. Well, the class done got rid of using the name. They ain't saying my name no more. I done heard lectures where you ain't saved in the Y-A-H-S-H-U-A. Boldly saying that. Yeah. You ain't saved no Y. That's just an attributes, reputation, and character. That's what he's looking for. He ain't looking for no name. Name don't make a difference. See? Now the people were infected with that. You see? And how did they get infected? How did he get infected with that? Because he took all the speakers off the floor. See, everybody stopped. They stopped calling up speakers, and they start sending what? Videos out from L.A., from the city of the lost angels. Hmm. Right? See? And when they start sending them videos out, see, we people didn't realize what was happening, see? But they was getting infected, you see? Now, the word co, you know what that means? Like your co-pilot, co-captain, mm-hmm. Right? Co-author, right? Right? Some, you know, it ain't take too long to realize what that means, right? Right? Now, look at this now. Stay with me. How you doing, sweetheart? How did the people get infected? They start sending out what? Videos. You ain't saved no YHS. Look at the evidence there. You got the videos at your house. You go watch them. I ain't lying. You ain't saved no Henry. That's just a whatever. But the bottom line is the people got infected. Now, what does cold mean? With. Right? With what? With what?
Videos.
COVID. That's cold with the videos. How you doing, sir? Good to have you. Cold video. COVID. See? In this over this 10-year period that he took away their name. They took away the name, right? And then, now the word corona means crown. Did you know that? Mm-hmm. Okay. Means crown. Right? And the culmination of all this, you see, ended up with them putting some crowns, see, on their heads. See? Now, this ain't by happenstance, because then 2019, the world got to reflect what's going on in Idiomar. Oh, Yahweh Code. He said, all right, you want to say my name? You don't want to breathe. You breathe my name, I'll be giving the whole time. Right? Well, I'm going to take the breath out of the whole world mouth. Mm. See? See, that's what I'm going to do. See? I told you that the true name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua. I told you don't give Henry Clifford Kinley no credit. And that's what you did. And you caused my people to forget my name. As in, what's that over there? 23:25 of one of them. Can't remember. Deuteronomy. Not Deuteronomy. Jeremiah 23:25, right? Call my people to forget my name, right? Right? When he labored, right? Say the name don't make a difference. But look, now, if you can't breathe, you can't live, right? 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 If you ain't giving credit to Yahweh, you ain't got no hope of salvation. See? 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 Now look at this. That ain't the only thing that happened at that time. Because what happened is this. Oh, man. See? Now, I don't want anybody to take this the wrong way now. All right? But ask me if I'm not lying. Right? So now, they don't realize what they was doing. Because when you give the credit that's due to who? Yahweh, right? To that of a mere creature or a name associated with a creature, when you do that, I'm going to tell you now, when you give credit to a creature instead of the creator, I just said it another way, just to make sure you understand it, right? Then guess what you're doing? Somebody say blasphemy. Somebody say this. I see y'all got a little couple of little ideas, but guess what it is? Homosexuality.
Mm. Spiritual homosexuality.
When a creature works, that's same sex, man. That's the real definition of homosexuality. When a creature gives credit to another creature or a name associated with another creature. You see? Now that's called spiritual homosexuality. See that? See? Cold-blooded.
Hallelujah.
IDMR became Sodom and Gomorrah. IDMR became spiritual sissies. Spiritual homosexuals. When you give credit from creature to another creature, that's spiritual sissetry.
See?
And then in 20, now look, that's, and we talking about the same period of time now. Now guess what happened? In the world, there's one or two states that had legalized what? Homosexual marriage. Man with a man, woman with a woman. Just two states. Massachusetts and Vermont, right? Two. But over a period of 10 years from 2006 to 2016, it turned into 33 states. They started ratifying legislation and so on and so forth. See. So what I'm trying to show you is the same time frame that IDMR was becoming spiritually gay. The world was becoming spiritually gay. Look it up. Oh, it's cold-blooded. It's cold. It's too cold. Now, you got to be able to see this, you see. Topping it off with their little coronation ball, right? Right? And then Yahweh dropped the what? The corona. And then you could go back and look and see that how they got infected was with the COVID. Oh, through the videos. This is the perfect timetable that Yahweh operating right here. See? And right in front of our faces. And if you don't let you see it, you'll never know. If you don't let you see it, you'll be caught up in it. That's why Dr. Kennedy said that in his last lecture. He said, they're going to be those that's going to get on this flow and tell you things against what you have been taught.
Right?
Right? And he said, now, if you haven't learned your lesson, you will be what? Caught away with it. Right? And what did he say? He said, you will be caught away with it if you haven't learned your lesson, right? You see? See? Now, look. He reenacted the whole thing right in front of your face. Just what he was talking about right here. Right? See? And guess what happened to the school? Huh? We talking about the end of the world? See? Guess what? See, guess what? He shut it down. He shut the whole thing down. You ain't use my name no more? Okay, I'm gonna show y'all. I'll shut it down. See? I'll shut the whole world down. See? You won't say my name? You won't use my name? See? You gonna ignore my name? Right? See? Now look. Everybody don't know this, no. But it's all, Dr. Kelly told us, look in the newspapers. You see? See? Now look at this. Boy, Yahweh is something else. See, in the beginning, you had something happen, right? See, and when I talk about the beginning, I'm talking about in heaven. In heaven. Now see, you had, see, Yahweh created, right, a Luciferian spirit, right, and he said he wanted to do something. What did he say he wanted to do? He said he wanted to do what? Ascend above. Hold on now. He wanted to do what? He wanted to ascend above the cloud and do what?
Be like the Most High.
Now, I want to say something about that, be like. And keep this in mind. This is extremely important. See, when somebody wants to be like somebody, what we normally think is, oh, he want to be like him. Oh, he want to be like him. No, that's not what that means. What that means is when you won't be like somebody, see, when you won't be like somebody, you don't think you them.
Right.
You think you somebody else other than them. If you won't be like them, right?
Mm-mm.
See, but he was made from the same substance too. You see? Now that's the same trick that the devil been playing all the way down. Now watch this. See, what he told Eve in the garden. He said, now look, Eve, thou shalt not surely die, for Elohim doeth know what? That in the day that you partake of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, what's going to happen?
You shall surely die.
No. He said, in the day you partake of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, right?
Or you become wise.
Yeah, that's right, my brother. That's it, boy. You got head. But now there's a word right after wise. What's that word? Wise what?
Like?
Ass.
Okay.
Uh-oh, you done tricked Eve now. Eve was already Elohim. She didn't know she was, right? But Dr. Kelly said, he sent Eve on a wild goose chase trying to become something what she already was. Mm-hmm. Eve didn't need no exchange. How you like that? Because she was already made from this pure spirit substance, right? As a matter of fact, he made her from the head. Did he make her from the head? He made her from the chest cavity, which is the bone, and from the abdominal cavity, which is the womb, right? See, Eve didn't have no head. Right? Now watch this. Okay, now. Oh, my goodness gracious. I got 5 minutes. Look, here's the beauty. They got a basketball player by the name of Kobe. What happened to him? On the same day USA put out COVID, Kobe, right? Now we use the word Kobe just now, right? Now Yahweh Elohim is the one being everything, but he was a Kobe. See, he wanted to be like those. That's Kobe. You never heard nobody named Kobe, right? But now look at this. Look at this. See. I'm going to try and run through this as quickly as I can. What happened to him? He was trying to ascend above the clouds. He was trying to ascend. He played for the Los Angeles Lakers. That's the Los Angeles going to the lake. Right? And look, now he's trying to ascend above the clouds. Right? Who else was doing that? Lucifer. And then they in the Black Mamba. That ain't too good. Right? Right? Cold B. Right? Yeah. Right? And now, same thing happened in heaven. What happened to Lucifer in heaven? He got kicked out of heaven, right?
Right.
Right? He got kicked out of heaven down into what? Earth. Or down into what? Hell.
Hell.
Right? What was Kobe riding in?
Helicopter.
A what?
Helicopter.
A what?
A
helicopter. Make you scratch your head, huh? And what? Now see Michael right here. Michael got a job. Michael chopping. Michael got a flaming sword. He'll chop you and kick you out the kingdom. See? What's that called? See, you can stick somebody with a sword, but also you can do what? You can stab them, right? Mm-hmm. You can chop them. What they call a helicopter? A chopper. Yahweh chopped that boy out the sky. Right? Because he want to be like Mike. He want to be like the Most High. That was his whole thing. I want to be like the Most High. I know you might be some Laker fans up in here. I don't care. I'm just showing you the purpose of Yahweh. You see? Now, I got about 3 minutes. I'm going to try and touch this real quick. You had a president, right? And Yahweh Elohim said that, at the end, the last trump shall sound, right? Right? Okay. Now watch this. Ooh, I appreciate the time y'all gave me. Right? Now, we know that Trump is a con man. If you can't see that, you just... So all he was, a con man. What is a con? What's a con? It's a liar. Yeah. The man told over 25,000 lies in a four-year period. Divide 4 into 25. See what you come. And that's just the ones they got on tape. Right? Now, look at this. A con is a liar, right? Well, didn't they have one back there that was a liar too? Right? Now, Yahweh did with this thing here on January 6th, he repeated every single thing that happened in heaven. Everything. See? Now, look. Watch this now. See? Here you go. Now, there was one person, people don't realize this, one person got Trump elected. It was Kellyanne Conway. Mm-hmm. Okay? Kellyanne Conway. You heard of her before?
Yeah.
Kellyanne Conway? Mm-hmm. That was his campaign manager. She went to all those states and got those people out to vote, and that's how he won. Michigan, Wisconsin, and so on and so forth, right? Right? Okay. What was her name? Kellyanne Conway. You see? Now, see? Kellyanne Conway. Now, when she... Because Dr. Kelly told us to read the news, right? Now, when Trump got in office, what happened? Right? See? We just put one for Conway. Right? Kellyanne Conway. When Trump got in office, he had one guy to help him accomplish everything. He was running the Senate. What was his name? Mitch what? Mitch McConnell, it's another con. I'm telling you, Yahweh put the names on the creatures. Mitch McConnell, right? See? And now he been conning people and so on and so forth. See? Now the whole time, they got what? They putting out, Kellyanne Conway started a thing called Alternative Facts. What is an alternative fact? That's a lie. The government coming up with another name for a lie. Alternative fact. Now you got Kellyanne Conway. You got Mitch McConnell. Now guess what else you got? What that created was conspiracy theories. Because all across the United States, just conspiracy theories. People, oh, good, I'm down. Now with those conspiracy theories, guess what? They took those conspiracy theories. And look, what did they raid on January 6th?
White House.
Yep. They raided the
Congress.
Congress.
Right? Mm-hmm. Right? And look, one more minute. That's all I'm going to take. And then Congress, right? And the laws that are made, because that's where all the laws come from. You see? So you make all the laws, vote on the laws in Congress, right? And they add those to the what? Constitution, another con. We say, oh, men are created equal. We hold these truths to be self. That's a con. See? And they raided the Capitol, so there was an insurrection. Just like there was an insurrection back here. Had an insurrection at the end. Down here. Right? And he lost the election, and they kicked him out, right? Mm. Right? So he had to leave office, right? Right? Where did he go? Where at in Florida? Mar-a-Lago. They got a whole lot more to this, but I'm just giving you the little icing on the cake part. You know how people eat the icing, they don't get the cake? They got cake to this. But now look, what does Mar mean? You ever heard of martial arts? That's when you whip and beat somebody, right? Didn't that happen in heaven? They had a war in heaven. He got his behind kicked, right? He lost the election, right? Right? He got beat. Yahshua's visage was marred more than any man. That's a whipping and a beating. Then you got martial arts. Right? Right? Some people get married and get beat. See? That's a marriage, right? But that's a whole nother story. But now, that's what that word means. Does anybody know what Lago means? Somebody say lake? Well, Donald Trump left the White House and the presidency after getting beat in the election. And look, he got kicked down into Mar-a-Lago. That means the lake. Where did Lucifer get kicked to? Where his final destination?
The lake.
How could that man be the president and get kicked down to Mar-a-Lago and that mean the lake? That's the most beautiful type of shadow you could. It's right there in front of your face. I'm sorry I took a little bit over. But look, oh man, it's just incredible what Yahweh is doing right now. And the key is understanding that Yahweh is pure spirit and you pure spirit. The Holy Spirit. Don't let nobody tell you that you not Yahweh. Don't let nobody tell you this. See, they say, everybody Yahweh, but everybody not Yahshua.
Yeah.
Oh, they're going to get you with that one.
Yeah.
When it's 3-1, right?
Right?
See? Don't let nobody tell you that everybody Yahweh, but the two manifestations of Yahweh is Yahshua and the devil. Mm-hmm. Incorrect. Mm-hmm. It's Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua. Or incorporeal, incorporeal, mm-hmm. All right? Mm-hmm. And don't let nobody steal your salvation by telling you that you're something else other than him. Because
right.
Yahweh is Elohim. Elohim is Yahshua. And he omnipresent.
Right.
And the flesh don't have nothing to do with it.
Right.
All right? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All praise be to Yah. Oh, I'm sorry I went over a little bit. But fall for the core. Oh, yeah, okay.
Current events, something else, man.
Thank you, Dr. Arden Michael Jones. Truly appreciated that. For our next speaker, I would like to call visiting with us from the Las Vegas branch, Dr. Leslie Lyons.
Put this right here. Everybody can hear me? Okay. I'd like to say good afternoon to the visiting brother who came out here to visit at the Ontario branch, and also to brother who is hopefully listening to what thus saith Yahweh. I enjoyed what the previous speaker had to say in relation to our Heavenly Father Yahweh and how he has manifested himself within this creation that we can all take hold and come to some kind of profound knowledge and understanding of him. And by just taking the things that he has done created, which is this creation, and where we all have no excuse not to know him as he really is and actually exists. And one excuse, or there's really no excuse, is just by beginning with this threefold tabernacle pattern. Right. This threefold tabernacle pattern is, you know, consists of a most holy place, a holy place, and a court round about, but one tabernacle. Okay? This right here is what Yahweh, who is pure spirit, see, the word transmuted himself into this shape and form, you know, of this pattern to reveal to Moses, you know, how he had brought in the entire creation, okay? And by understanding this pattern, that when we're going to, we will take it real simple, one, two, three, as our founder has expressed to us, that if you can count one, two, three, and you can begin on that road or begin on that path to understand something about our Creator, okay? In that He is the Father, He is the Word, O Son, and He is the Holy Spirit. You see, in that His name is Yahweh. See, this is the name of our Heavenly Father, who is Yahweh. You see, and as the previous speaker has said, Yahweh, here on this chart, it says spirit, but we come to know that it's pure spirit, okay? And that Yahweh, you know, taking on shape and form as Elohim, you know, in this in supercorporeal form as Elohim, you see, only seen in divine visions and understood in divine revelation, and later on manifesting himself in the creation. I like to put it like that, not just only a man, but in the entire creation, as Yahshua. You see, Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua, these three are one. Not a trinity, you see, a unity, okay? All Yahweh have done was just, you know, it came out of this pure spirit state and condition, and in that he had chosen a cloud to symbolize himself so that, to show that how that he has been taken on shape and form, you know, as Elohim, and manifesting himself in this entire creation. This would be likening to the head, you see. This would be likening to, if you want to, we can look at it like this. Very easy way to try to understand it. You know, we use this picture of this body of a man, okay? Now, the man is threefold. Okay, in that he have a head cavity, chest cavity, abdominal cavity. Well, we come to realize that, and we should say this all the time, a head cavity, chest cavity, abdominal cavity. You look up the word cavity, that means something that's empty. There's nothing in here that's empty. So, correctly, come to realize that this is the head region, chest region, abdominal region. Makes sense now, right? Because there's something in here for us to come to a knowledge and understanding about our Creator as He really is and actually exists. Okay? Now, with this tabernacle pattern, okay, and very simple, you know, as it was shown to Moses, you know, up here when he was up on Mount Sinai, okay? There's steps in this tabernacle pattern that this high priest had to officiate of the oracles of, as a priest, officiating in this tabernacle, okay? And we have the gate as the first step. We have the second step, which is this altar, right? And then the third step is this brazen laver. And the fourth step will be the door, okay? One, two, three, and the door will be four. The fifth step will be what? Holy place. The sixth step will be what? The veil, the second veil, okay? And the seventh step will be the most holy place, okay? Now, let's bear in mind that, you know, this high priest that officiated in this tabernacle, he had to make a round trip, okay? Everything we do is a round trip. Somebody said, well, what do you mean by that? Well, there was a time that we all was without shape and form.
There you go.
You see? Mm-hmm. And that, you know, before we was even conceived of or take on shape and form and came through the loins of our mother, you see, that's Yahweh, or is likened to Yahweh without shape and form. Now, someone would say, Yahweh always been in shape and form. Well, we could, it's right here, just as plain. I mean, pictorial illustrations all around us to show that Yahweh was not always in shape and form. Okay? So, in that, he took on shape and form. It even says it in the moderation. You see? And, oh, man, if somebody can read that, I'm trying to see where I can see where it's. But anyway.
That, huh? Yahweh knowing that man could not perceive of
right.
him.
Right. Yahweh knowing that man could not what?
Yahweh knowing that man could not perceive of him in his pure spirit state.
In his pure spirit state.
Took on shape and form.
Okay, the reason why the man could not perceive of him in his pure spirit state is because the man himself is in shape and form. Okay? He's going to have to understand something about shape and form, or how Yahweh then, you know, then transmuted himself into, for him to understand something about Yahweh or his creator. You see what I'm saying? It makes sense, right? In other words, how, okay. I'll go ahead on with this, okay? See, when Yahweh appeared unto Moses, okay, Moses is in shape and form right here, right? That's why he had to come and shape and form and manifest himself unto Moses, even as a man that he had seen down here in Egypt. You see, that's a beautiful thing. You mean to tell me that this angel that Moses had saw out here in the wilderness, or out here in the wilderness when he was taking care of his father-in-law's sheep, he saw an angel in this bush, and this bush was being burning. Consumed, burning. Not burning. Being consumed,
right.
Okay? And what was in this bush was an angel that spoke to him, and at the same time as it was speaking to Moses at this burning bush, this angel had a body that was down here in Egypt, astral projecting himself up here to Moses, and was giving him instructions to come down here to Egypt. I mean, that's some power. Oh, that's what we call them powers latent in man. Now, all of these here, we talk about these attributes, you know, which is on that is depicted on this chart here. Divine wisdom, divine intelligence, knowledge, love, beauty, justice, foundation, power, and strength. These are just the nine primary attributes. Mm-hmm. That took on this shape and form, whom we call Elohim, Yahweh Elohim.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? But if he took on shape and form in this state as a man that can only be seen in divine visions in Revelation like he did here. He also took in shape and form as a man manifested in the flesh here. You see how pretty that is? In other words, he hasn't appeared in a state that we call the corporeal, and also in this state here, which we call the incorporeal. Mm-hmm. Beautiful of how Yahweh, and that's the only two manifestations that Yahweh Elohim have ever manifested himself in, to make himself known unto his creatures. Okay? Now, here's Moses. Now I want to get what's that, Jeremiah, where you said, take my name to naught? We talked about it earlier. Read that for me, please.
Jeremiah 23, starting at 25.
Okay.
I have heard what the prophet said, that now, prophesied lies.
Jeremiah is saying, but we know that, who is really saying these words? Is it Jeremiah saying this? Or is it the Holy Spirit that's in Jeremiah that he's now realized it's Yahshua who's speaking these words? Mm-hmm.
Right.
Am I right or wrong?
Right.
Okay, read on. So what he's saying or what we read now, we're going to hear what Yahshua's saying, right? Read
that on. Prophesied lies in my name,
now
saying.
He's saying about these what? The prophets that prophesied lies in my name?
Mm-hmm.
Man, this was going on back way before. Look. We got this age and dispensation chart, right? We should be here. They were prophesying lies in this age, post-Diluvian age. Am I right? If I'm wrong, let me know. Okay, read on.
That prophesied lies in my name, saying, I have dreamed, I have dreamed.
I have dreamed, and I have dreamed. Read on.
How long shall this be in the heart of the prophets that prophesy lies?
Mm-hmm.
Yea, they are prophets of deceit of their own heart.
They are prophets of deceit of their own hearts. We have the same thing coming down here now. Yahweh don't change. He just manifests himself into, you know, in other words, the principles are the same. The manifestations are different. See, that's how we can always catch it. You know, Yahweh in that he overturning and overturning. Read.
Which think to cause my people to forget my name by their dreams.
Think to forget my people to cause or to forget my name. See, as the previous speaker has shared with us, you know, about how, you know, Yahweh have taken away the name, you know, out of the whole world. You see? And because they was trying, or that same thing in heaven, don't want you to come, or really, I just put it like this, they don't want you to come to the reality or the spiritual reality of your inheritance, okay? And our inheritance is here, you see? Our inheritance looks like the children of Israel. The children of Israel, their inheritance was here in Canaan's land. You see, our ultimate destination is right here in Canaan's land. We don't want to just, oh, okay, we out here in the court roundabout. We're going to go through the gate. We're going to go through this tabernacle pattern here as far as these steps. And we get to the door. And as it says over there in Matthew, stand in the holy place. Bear in mind, this veil has been rent. Okay, we're supposed to be right here in the most holy place, which is likened to Canaan's land itself. Read.
Which think to cause my people to forget my name by their dreams, which they tell every man to his neighbor, mm-hmm. as their fathers have forgotten my name
as
for Baal.
As their fathers have forgotten my name. Well, this is what happened in the Institute. They have forgotten the father's name. They have forgotten the son's name. Read over there in Proverbs where it says, who had know his name, the father and his son. Read that. I think it's Proverbs. Yeah, read that.
Proverbs 30 and 4.
Proverbs 30 and 4.
Who hath ascended up into heaven, or descended?
Who have ascended up into heaven and descended. Who have ascended up into heaven? Now bear in mind, now Moses is having a vision right here, most holy place. And descended what?
Who hath gathered the wind in his fist?
Who have gathered the wind in his fist? Okay.
Who hath bound the waters in a garment?
Who have bound the waters in a garment?
Who hath established all the ends of the earth? What is his name?
What is his name?
And what is his son's name,
and
if thou knowest it?
His son's name, if thou knowest. The only way you're going to know the Father's name and his name is Yahshua. Yahweh has to reveal it to you. You see, and he ain't just revealing it to you. He's revealing to his son in you. See, it's the son that do the work of the father. You see, go ahead and get the scripture lesson, which was Galatians 3:1. Now, this has been Galatians, the third chapter, has always been one of the scriptures in the New Testament that I really enjoyed and like. And we'll go ahead and get into this. You know, go ahead.
Oh, foolish Galatians.
Oh, foolish Galatians. Okay, we're going to bring it down to where we are right now. Oh, foolish IDMR. Mm-hmm. Read.
Who hath bewitched
you? Now, who hath bewitched you? Yeah, I said that. See, but y'all think it's less saying that. Read on.
That ye should not obey the truth.
That you should not obey the truth. He told you about his name. My name is Yahweh, and there's something else. Is that what it say?
Before
my name, wait a minute. My name is Yahweh, and what?
None other.
There's none else. Mm-hmm. Read on.
Before whose eyes Yahshua the Messiah hath been evidently set forth as crucified among you.
Look, he paid the price. Yahweh himself came down and paid the price for all of us. It's evident, even to the point where we are right now today. This is 2021, right? Do you know that date has to do and is based on this man being crucified here? The date? The whole world go by what has happened here. Read on.
This only would I learn of you.
This only would I learn of you. Talking about IDMR. Read on.
Received ye the Holy Spirit by the works of the law.
Now, did you receive the Holy Spirit by the works of the law? Did we receive the Holy Spirit by the coming to class, being to class on time, you know, doing this and doing that, singing in choir, all that stuff? Did we receive the Holy Spirit by that? Read.
Or by the hearing of faith.
Oh, by the hearing of faith. See, that's what it was. Yahweh brought us down here to hear his son, you see. And Yahweh then what he did, like this picture right here, or this chart, is taking our picture. You see, Yahweh, you know, in that he is of this pure spirit substance, took on shape and form, manifested himself in the flesh or transfigured right before the children of Israel and spoke. Same thing he's doing with us now in these schools. Call up, our first speaker is going to be da-da-da-da-da, whatever. But it's the words that's coming out the vessels, which is and only Yahweh himself. I don't care if it's a child, female, male, old, young, whoever's up here, and the only speaker is Yahweh himself. He said, I'm Yahweh, and there's something else. I'm Yahweh, and there's none else.
Right.
So who's speaking? It's Yahweh. He's always been the speaker. Yeah. I remember, sharing with this, with a brother we talked to, And he was telling me about Mary Jo Harris. Is that? Yeah, Mary Jo Harris. And Dr. Kinley was, you know, they wasn't calling him up on the floor too much, or they haven't called him up on the floor. So she had asked Dr. Kinley and said, you know, Yeah, pulled him on the side. And she said, well, Dr. Kinley, you know, we haven't heard from you. And when you gonna get on the floor? Dr. Kinley said, Mary Jo Harris, I'm surprised of you. I'm just surprised at you. I'm the only one that's been on the floor. That ever been on the floor. You see, again, I'm Yahweh, and there's something else. I'm Yahweh, and there's none else. So bear in mind, whoever comes up on this floor, Yahweh used and has always used vessels to execute his purpose or to say the things that will edify us all so that we can become, or in other words, we can become, I hate to say the word become, in other words, to be made fully conscious and aware of truly who we are. You see? We are Yahweh. Somebody say, I don't believe that. You got a devil going on. You know, it's a devil, right? Well, you know, if you won't believe that, that's fine.
For real.
But I ain't.
For real.
I'm not. You see? And I know many of you in here is not, and come to that conscious realization too. You see? But there's only one speaker. You see? And that speaker is Yahweh himself. You see? Just as though he had spoke to Moses here. See? At this burning bush. And can you imagine how this same angel that appeared unto Moses at this burning bush, and when Moses, he told him to come down to Egypt, and when he came down to Egypt, that very same angel that he saw at this burning bush, he saw in the flesh. Wasn't Yahshua down here? See what I'm saying? He's with him right here. I mean, it's evident Moses ain't had a problem with it. You know what I mean? Because he's with him out here at Mount Sinai. Okay? So, oh, it's just beautiful how this thing is. This is real, folks. This is no joke. We have come into the General Assembly of Yahweh, where there's an innumerable host of angels, you know, that Yahweh has then, you know, set forth so that, you know, we can, beyond a shadow of a doubt or without excuse. And there's none. There's no excuse, you know, for us to know anything about our Heavenly Father in spirit and in truth. You know, in that he didn't pitch the whole creation. You see, he didn't manifest his spirit in you. You see, and he's then given you a body where, you know, you can begin to understand something about Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua, and that these three are one, and that we were created in his image and in his likeness, you see. And there's no division, you see, in this, you see. And this right here is the fundamental, I say, foundation of beginning to understand something about Yahweh as he really is and actually exists, you see. Now, like I said earlier, our ultimate goal is to reach Canaan's land, most holy place. You see what I'm saying? Or the land of the Chaldeans, or Ur, you know. Oh, man, it's just beautiful how this thing is, you know. Now, one thing is that academically, You're not gonna try to wrestle this revelation from Yahweh. He's gonna have to reveal it to you. And see, and how he's going to reveal it, it's either gonna be what? Two ways, right? He's either gonna reveal it by vision, see what I'm saying? Giving you vision, or he gonna put it in a vessel, gotta say it to you. And he's going to have the ability to prove it, demonstrate it, beyond a shadow of a doubt. Like our founder has said, yes, I had a divine vision and revelation. Don't believe me because I said it. Make me what?
Prove it.
Until what?
You're satisfied.
Well, that's how that goes here with each and every one of us. If you say something, we say something. What do you mean by that? We should have the ability to prove it. We should have the ability to demonstrate it, you know? I remember when I first came to class, or when I first was introduced to this class, it was a guy, he's deceased now, but he just demonstrated about, to get me to see about the death, burial, and resurrection of the Messiah. I mean, he demonstrated, you know, by, in other words, he fell out on the floor, you know, and like he was dead, you know. Then I was down in the basement, you know. He had his bed over there. He hopped in the bed and pulled the covers over him. You see what I'm saying? Like into a burial. Mm-hmm. And then after he kind of, you know, did that for a while, he just pulled the covers back and stood up. That's some power. You see what I'm saying? This power right here, you see, all those powers laden in man, it's in each and every one of us, always has been. You see, and Yahweh himself has the ability and is the only one that can demonstrate and his power so that we can hopefully come to the conscious realization of who we are. Mm-hmm. You know, we always have been, or I've thought, you know, just like Yahweh, you know, he has with our founder, okay, he's manifested himself in our founder, Henry C. Kinley, as well in each and every one of us, and is just playing a role as Henry Clifford Kinley, just like he's playing a role as, you see what I'm saying? But, and pretending to be you, her. But the reality of it is, that's Yahweh. That's who you are.
That's right.
You see? And, with that, I'm going to just go ahead on and yield the flow. And there is a lot of things, like it's been said, we're in some perilous times, folks. There are some things that Yahweh is about to devastate this world. He's about to show. You see, he's already have, but it ain't getting no better. You see, and it's with the hopes that we come to realize that our origin is here. You see what I'm saying? Our destination is here. See, this is our inheritance. You see, and one thing that is eternal, see, the flesh is not eternal. Mm-hmm. Flesh is temporal.
Right.
But the spirit, that's eternal. See, and you must know that this is our parental substance right here. Must know that this is where we come from, you see. And keep in mind that Yahweh in this state and condition right here, or what we call the ontological perfection, is when there's no more shape and form, you see. And when Yahweh came out of this pure spirit state into a shape and form, we say this is what? Yahweh. What kind of clothes he got on?
Working clothes.
Work clothes. So we in our work clothes. You see what I'm saying? But we're going to have to soon come out of our work clothes right back into who we are. So with that, I just like to yield the floor and enjoy being here with the brethren, and hopefully Yahweh will see fit and manifest another time that, you know, we can share the good news and share this gospel. I also want to extend an invitation to the brethren here in Ontario. You're welcome anytime to come and visit with us in Vegas. It's a few of us, but it's enough that we can when it's all said and done. Hallelujah.
Thank you very much, Dr. Lyons, for the words of encouragement. For our third speaker for today, I would like to call the president of the Ontario branch, Dr. Christopher Williams.
It is afternoon, so, right?
Yeah.
I did appreciate the previous speakers, and I thank you all for visiting with us. I know y'all came from a long distance, and we truly appreciate the visit. There's been a lot said on the floor today, and I'm gonna try to keep in the same vein as, well, as much as I can. And you know, I don't think I'm gonna be as smooth as Arden, but I'll do the best I can. You know, he's from Louisiana, he's smooth, right? Anyhow. It's been said on this floor at least twice that we are in perilous times, right? And I don't disagree. But name a time where we haven't been in perilous times. In fact, let's just take this Asian's dispensations chart. And let's look at some perilous times. I believe in Revelation it talks about there's a war in heaven. Perilous times. I believe there were some perilous times in that garden,
okay.
Right? Noah preached 120 years about some perilous times.
Right.
And I believe there was perilous times in Abraham's day when there was a global pandemic where there's no food. There's a famine,
right. Yeah.
Right? Israelites did nothing but go to war, get beat up, chewed up, spit out. I mean, this is perilous times for these Israelites. And call me crazy, but during the Roman time, perilous times, they was always fighting wars. I mean, name a time it wasn't a war. We had a Revolutionary War. We have a Civil War. We had World War I, World War II, Vietnam. Perilous times. 90s, we had Desert Storm. I believe the Palestinians and Israelites have been fighting since Israel got the land. Middle East been trying to kill Israel since their inception.
Yes.
Africans been fighting each other. America's in everybody's war.
Yeah.
China plotting. Now today we got pandemic. We got Syria. We got Afghanistan. North Korea, South Korea. We got everything going on. Perilous times. Name a time when we ain't in perilous times. What's the point?
We need a savior.
No, we've been saved. What's the point? Point is, we're supposed to keep our eye on the prize.
Mm.
Everybody focus on everything else going on in the world. It has nothing to do with you.
Mm-hmm.
Last time I checked, you got to take care of you, right? You got to take care of you. Everybody got to take care of themselves. Everybody mad at Joe Biden for evacuating his troops. He's just doing the same thing the guy before him was going to do. He just got left holding the bag. That's the nation of the beast. Remember when Obama took office? He got left holding the bag.
Right.
Bush said, deuces. Ain't nobody. They start talking about him. He got out of the kitchen because it got too hot. Next thing you know, here comes Obama. He's like, oh, gosh. Obama had hair like Arden when he went in. Now he look like me. That's the point. Like, we up there worrying about everything else under the sun. You know, it's about Yahshua Messiah. That's what this gospel is here about. Get me the scripture lesson real quick. But before we get that, just to bring a couple points that have been brought up, we got Isaiah 46, 9 and 10, and then Malachi 3 and 6. Give me Isaiah first. We got 15 minutes, so we don't need some. I need you to do it expeditiously.
Isaiah 46, 9. Remember the former things of old, for I am El, and there is none else.
Read.
I am Elohim, and there is none like me.
I believe Leslie said, there ain't none but Yahweh here. You are who you've been looking for. If there's a preacher, is there someone speaking on the floor, it is Joshua the Messiah himself speaking through that man. Or the Holy Spirit, right? So if there is none else other than Yahweh himself, what are we worried about? Why are we worried about some war, Syria, all this other stuff? That's their problem. You worry about you. And right now your salvation is in jeopardy. Your soul is in jeopardy. But we worry about everything else. He said, I am Yahweh and there's none else. There is none like me. Mm-hmm. In fact, you want to know how there's none like me? I could declare the end right from the beginning.
Right.
Malachi.
Malachi 3 and 6. For I am Yahweh, I change not.
Wait, what are you talking about? We change not. This is old school. It's new school, right? Right? It's like going from a pager to a cell phone. We were watching a movie the other day, and it said, beep, 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 beep. She said, what is that? That's a pager. What is a pager? That's how we used to communicate back in the days. When your girl texts 911, and oh, I got to go, right? That's what we used to do. She was taking that 911, like, get here right now. I know how you operate, girl. You ain't messing with nobody. Anyhow, then we got real cool. We got alphanumeric pagers. Remember? I thought it was cool. I was the first one in school. I'm like, yeah, I got alphanumeric. I thought it was dope. Chirp, yeah, we had that. That next tail. But he said, I'm Yahweh, and I change not.
Right.
But yet, man chose to change his name to Baal. All right. Yeah. The Lord. I had a conversation this morning. Why do you go to church? Oh, because it gives me perspective about life. What? You didn't know that already? What? You need a preacher to tell you about perspective?
Yeah.
You can get that through meditation. Read a book or two. What you going to church for? Well, all right. Let me give you an easier question. What is his name and what's his son's name? We read that earlier, right? I got this. I thought they was clever. YHWH. Really? That's what we doing? Okay. Well, the name is Yahweh, so I can help you out. What's his son's name? Jesus. Woo, okay. Jesus. I said, in John 5:39, you read down, it says, I come in my father's name. Well, if he came in his father's name, how can Jesus be his name? Oh, that's a good point. No, I know that. That's why I asked the question. The next thing I asked is, then what's his name? Because just so you know, Jesus, there's no J sound or J in the Greek, Hebrew, and Latin, and his name was written in that. So the question is, what was his name? And just so you know, his name is, that name Jesus is Greek and Babylonian, and Christ is Hindu. So you praise him to all those people. So what is his name? I guess it depends on what religion you are. Oh, my gosh. This is an educated individual. Very intelligent individual. And even they are duped. What'd you say? He came here to deceive the whole world? Mm-hmm. Satan did the great. He's doing a great job, right? Because the whole world is duped into believing that his name is something that is not. In Exodus, it says, this is my name forever and a memorial to all generations. And then in Jeremiah, are you going to change my name to Baal? But I'm Yahweh and I change not. There is none else. So who's being duped? Right? So let's bring it a little closer to home because we've been talking about this today. In the good old days, you can go to any class. Blood, water, spirit, for it. Blood, water, spirit, for it. I mean, you got a whole chart. Blood, water, spirit, for it. Blood, water. We can do it any class you went to. Blood, water, spirit, 40. Name is Yahweh, Elohim, Yahshua. I change not.
theme song. Romans 1, 19 and 20, Isaiah 46, 9 and 10. We hit all the hits. Now we don't even read scriptures. Dr. Kinley said it before he took off the flesh. Listen, man. People are going to say some things you didn't even see coming. Everything that you thought was normal, it's not going to be normal. Just stay in the faith. Mm-hmm. Just keep preaching the gospel the way you know it. Let them do what they're going to do. Because guess what? It was set up to be so. Right here in the realm of eternity. Mm-hmm. It wasn't like this was news. He told you it was going to happen. And why are we upset about it?
Right.
What you changing for? What you leaving for? He told you this was going to happen. But yet, we have some that want to elevate themselves and exalt themselves with a title just so that they can be the man, right? Mm. Like that matters. Who wants to be the dean? Really? Really? Man, I don't even want to be the dad. Not that I got any problem with your son, but come on, man, you're expensive. I'm still paying for this cat. Are you kidding me?
I heard that, Chris.
Who wants to be in charge? Listen, it was easy for him. Creative heaven and earth, puppet master, gets to do whatever he wants. But even Yahweh follows a divine order of affairs. There's a pattern he created. He said, listen, I'm going to make it real simple so anyone that wants to know me can know me. I'm going to create a pattern. I'm going to pattern after you to make it simple. If you know you, you know me. But yet, we still want to flub that up. Word about who shot John. Ooh, I look good in this outfit. Really? We as carnal can be. But guess what? They were carnal. Give me the scripture lesson, because this is about as good as it gets. Then I'll sit my butt down. Start at one.
Oh, foolish Galatians.
Because then some fools, too. Read.
Who hath bewitched you that
you
did not obey the
Spirit? Who? Who bewitched you? That means someone put a spell on you. Read.
Before whose eyes Yahshua the Messiah hath been evidently set forth as crucified among you.
He came and did things that nobody else can do in front of you, and you still bewitched. Really? Come on. Millions of people saw a con man in office and still believe that he's the best thing that ever happened to America. Give me a break. Who has bewitched you? And I'm not talking about them back home swamp dwellers. Highly educated people. You got to be kidding me. Even the educated can't figure this out. Somebody had to bewitch them. Read.
This only what I learn of you. Receive ye the Spirit by the works of the law or by hearing of the faith.
Read.
Are ye so foolish, having begun in the Spirit?
Mm-hmm.
Are ye now made perfect by the flesh?
Wait. Here's going. We got people that sat in these seats, preached this gospel for 20 years, and went back to the church. You gotta be kidding me. How foolish are you? We got people that have been to school from a little wee kid to the highest of the highest, voting for fools, putting fools in office. Can't even read a book to know that his name is not Baal. What fools are these? We got people in this class looking at a man instead of the man. Really? That's what we're doing? What happened? How foolish do we have to be? But I'm Yahweh and there's none else. I'm Yahweh and I change not. Read.
Have ye suffered so many things in vain?
Mm-hmm.
If it be yet in vain, he therefore that ministereth to you the Spirit and worketh miracles among you, doeth he it by the working of the law or by the hearing of faith?
Read.
Even as Abraham believed Yahweh, and it is accounted to him for righteousness.
Read.
Know ye therefore that they which are of faith the same are the children of Abraham.
Listen, if some entity came to me and said, hey, through your seed, all the nations of the earth going to be blessed. And I look at my seed and be like, them? Like, really? Really? My seed? I mean, I know what I be doing. I know my seed going to be doing the same thing. Really? Can you imagine what Abraham was thinking when Yahweh came to him and said, hey, all nations of the earth are going to be blessed because of you. That's heavy. But yet, through faith, he believed and was counted unto righteousness. We had disciples who watched this man do miraculous things that no one else had ever done. And they had people that followed them because they had disciples too. So he had disciples and his disciples had disciples and everybody watching him and they still didn't believe. Who has bewitched you? Read.
And the scripture, foreseeing that Yahweh would justify the heathen through
mm-hmm.
faith,
mm-hmm.
preached before the gospel
mm-hmm.
unto Abraham,
mm-hmm.
saying, in thee all nations be blessed.
Read.
So then they which be of faith are blessed
uh-huh.
with faithful Abraham.
Read.
For as many as are of the works of the law are under the curse.
Mm-hmm.
For it is written, cursed is every one that continueth not in all things which are written in the book of the law to do them.
Mm-hmm.
But that no man is justified by the law
mm-hmm.
in the sight of Yahweh.
Listen, everybody, they all, listen, to this day, the Jews put all their stock in this law, but omit the ones that are not convenient for them. Nah, I ain't gonna kill no turtle dove. But I'm gonna condemn you if you say some bad words. Nah, I'm not gonna, you know, we're not gonna do all these other killings, but I dare you to drink some wine on a wrong day.
Right.
Really? That's what we're doing? That's the Jews. Don't get me started on the Christians. Really? I got friends to this day that'll tell you don't drink, don't smoke, don't do these things because that's a sin. But they be cheating on their wives and their husbands daily. They covet thy neighbor's wife or husband daily. They got graven idols, crosses, fish all over their place daily. I mean, we can go through the list. We only got to go through 10, the 613. Let's just go through the 10 that everybody know about. They sin every day according to that law. Not knowing that law is not valid in this age because he was there to take it out of the way. Because they was reading the book, but they heard Jimmy. They listened to Jimmy, but they didn't hear Jimmy. You get what I'm saying? You got to be here for that lecture. Read. We're almost there.
It is evident, for the just shall live by faith.
Read.
Now the law uh-huh. is not of faith,
uh-huh.
but the man that doeth these things
uh-huh.
shall live by them.
Read.
The Messiah hath redeemed us from the curse of the law.
He redeemed us from the curse of the law, meaning all these things that they pretend to do, put stock in, want to hold you accountable to that they don't want to do themselves. He redeemed us from this. So when you got your friends or your enemies trying to condemn you, you're not justified, you're this, that, and the other, just know you've been redeemed because we're here. I don't know who that is.
Sorry.
There is no power in this law. There's no redemption in this law. There's only redemption in him.
Right.
He wasn't saving anything but the ark. If you were in him and you resurrected with him, you are saved. You weren't there, but if you believed, then you are saved. He was just saving himself, but the only way to get to him is to get through him. You had to pay the man at the door.
Right.
Isn't that how you get into the club?
That's it.
All right, I got to hook up the doorman to get into the club, right? Yeah. Where is the doorman? We do it all the time. If you're in him, then you're in him. Because I'm Yahweh, and there is none else. Mm-hmm. I'm Yahweh, and I change not.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Don.
Business as usual.
Thank you, Dr. Williams. That will conclude this evening or today's lecture. We have a couple of announcements before we finish up here. So we'd like to welcome again and thank all of the brethren that came out to visit with us and our returning visitor. I guess he had to step out a little early, but we were glad to have him with us for you can relay that message for the time that he was. We have a card for Kabbalah Charles Moba, one of our brethren from Zambia. So if anybody would like to sign that card, it'll be out in the lobby. You can sign it. We're going to send it out to his family members for condolences during this time. Yeah, that's out there. Also, we have an announcement about an upcoming symposium for our brethren in Dallas. They have already secured a venue at the Hilton in Plano Grande Park in Plano, Texas. And the venue date will be December 10th through 12th of 2021. The hotel room will be $129 a night. And we'll have a registration website available. You can reach out to us, or let me see if I got an email. Yeah, you can reach out to us at idmrclassinfo@gmail.com for the registration info. And you can also reach out to Dr. Felicia Smith. And I don't know if I want to, I'm not going to post her phone number. Yeah. Yeah, just email for us for that information because I don't want to put that out there. Anyhow, that's all. We hold classes here. What?
We have a
business meeting next Sunday. All officers, please be advised. And everybody's invited, correct? We hold classes here at 1816 East Elma Court in Ontario, California on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. and on Sundays from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. Please bring all your friends and all your enemies because this is truly the place to learn something truthful about your Heavenly Father Yahweh. Let us all stand to be dismissed with a doxology taken from the last two verses of Jude. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise Elohim, our Savior, through Yahshua the Messiah, our Sovereign, belong glory and majesty, dominion and power, both before all time, now and ever. Let us all say, Hallelujah. Hallelujah.